Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. My sisters and brothers in Christ, may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Oh, my friends, sisters and brothers, Filipino community, it's good for me to be here. This is my second Simbahan Gabi Mass. I'll explain to you in my homily when did my first Simbahan Gabi experience happen. But this is a great tradition, and I pray that this tradition will really prepare you and prepare us well for Christmas, for the coming of the Emmanuel to us. So, as the people of God, people who are waiting for the coming of our Lord, we have the courage to express our sorrow because we know God is love. So we say, I confess the mind of God.
Lord, have mercy.
let us pray. Come quickly, Lord Jesus. Do not delay. We entrust ourselves to your love. Strengthen us for your coming and raise us up. You who live and reign with the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. In our first reading, David wants to build God a house where the Lord can stay close to his people. But God says, it is he who will be the house that is the lasting dynasty for David, from which the Messiah will come.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am, living in the house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in the tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go. Do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night, the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go, tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in?"
It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock, to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The favors of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness. Covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant, forever will I confirm your prosperity and establish your throne for all generations.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
You shall say of me, "You are my Father, my God, the Rock, my Savior." Forever I will maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm.
Forever I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Please all stand. Come and shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death.
First ever Simogadimas was in 1989. I was in Manila for a meeting of Jesuit Formandi with those were in formation. The organizers decided that it must experience the great excitement of Simogadim. Why not? Therefore, it was good. But then I found out that it was going to take place at 3 a.m. Wow, why so pious? It was a tiring day for me since I had to get up before 2 a.m. to travel to the church. So I'm glad that this Sambhagavimas is at 9 p.m. A lot more reasons. And I'm really happy to have this opportunity to celebrate this very special occasion with you, my Filipino sisters and brothers. It's very important for your tradition, in your blood as Catholics. David, King David, was a good guy. He felt bad when his Lord stayed in the tent while he is lounging comfortably the luxury of the house. It was God who made him king. How could he be so ungrateful? Right? Building a big temple for God should be the least that you could do for God. Does it not sound reasonable to you? Some reason is human. And being grateful is more than that. But God had a very different logic than David or humankind, if you may. himself, who made him commander of his people, Israel, and destroyed his enemies for him. God will be the one who made David famous and settled his people in the land where they would be well protected. And from the descendants of David, God will raise a son, whose rule of David's kingdom will be forever. It's God who did all that, not David. So in other words, how could David put God in a temple when God was the one who made David great and his kingdom lasting forever? As we prepare to celebrate the intervention, it's a direct intervention of this great God in our human history, by sending down his Son into our history in one of us. We must realize that we cannot box in God, neither can the church box in God or frame God in our own likeness, thinking God will be like us, feeling like us, thinking like us, and making judgment like us. We must not have that always assumptions. Instead, it is the Emmanuel who is coming into our lives to transform us, to put us under his wings, and to bring us back to the eternal kingdom of which we all have our shares. What is needed of us is our humble obedience to God's way in our lives. Just let God be God in our lives. And to help prepare others to welcome our Emmanuel, who is eager to touch their lives, their hearts, and to transform them from within, like God has done them for many of us. Not all of us. We must have experienced some form of transformation from our hearts, because God has touched our hearts. How to prepare others to welcome this Emmanuel? In my short life, I've seldom experienced any way of bringing people to God by yelling at them with doctrines or condemnations. I seldom see people coming to God because someone yelled at them. Okay? Or pointing fingers at them, judge them, condemn them, you know. But like the gospel, according to Luke today, God's mission for John the Baptist was, and I quote, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of God, our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The core message of the mission is salvation by the forgiveness of sins, not condemnation, and breaking into the darkness of those who very well be including us, right? Who are dwelling in the shadow of death. Death also means helplessness, hopelessness, right? Despair. With the tender compassion of God. So it is through mercy and forgiveness that many wounded or hardened hearts can be touched. Not criticism, not condemnation, and certainly not marginalization. May we be John the Baptist in this broken world, where severe restrictions on social mobility are put in place due to COVID-19 pandemic. People cannot go out. You know, in Hong Kong, we can go out, but at least we can still move around. Huh? But many places, we have to move around to visit the family. I understand recently when you cannot travel outside and take a break. Okay? I don't know, the set of pandemic may also prohibit some of you to return home for your home visits. You know, you must really miss seeing your family, and they miss seeing you. And that's the sad reality we do. And sometimes because of this COVID thing, pandemic, many families are facing tough financial issues. Okay? I learned from some principals in school say, now many people are asking them to, especially pay fee, fee pay schools. Can we cut down the tuition for them? And they said, some of them are even doctors, medical doctors. Why? Can you guess why? It's funny, but it's real. Because now we're wearing face masks, right? Flu has gone down. Cold has gone down. So the doctors have less patients. Less income. Right? So a lot of doctors are really just really give medicine for cold and flu, maybe. So there's some of this, I know, this is like a funny example, but it's not funny for the doctors, but it's really causing a lot of economic strain on us. So finally, let us approach each other with empathy and tender mercy. Let us welcome our Emmanuel into our lives with openness and eagerness to be transformed by Him. We need to be open before Jesus, before God can transform us. If we close our heart and our hearts, nothing much can be done for us. So this is a time when we suffering from the strain of the pandemic shows us how powerless we are, how vulnerable we are. And also show how God can fill us up and really strengthen us from within, facing this harsh reality. God bless you all, and I wish you a very blessed Christmas and a great spirit to all to do for you at the moment.
So now, the dawn announces a Savior coming from on high. We welcome Him with eager longing as we pray.
Faithful God, hear us.
Faithful God, hear us.
May the Church, the people of God, be set free from fear, hatred, anxiety, and the attachment of sin, we pray.
Faithful God, hear us.
May political and civil leaders receive the unwavering support from their constituents whom these leaders must serve with integrity, justice, and peace. We pray.
Faithful God, hear us.
As the season of Christmas draws near, may we strive to live moderately, prudent in our gift giving, in order to avoid wasteful spending.
Faithful God, hear us.
Attend to the souls of our dying brothers and sisters. May you reward them eternal life, we pray.
Faithful God, hear us.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Faithful God, hear us.
Faithful God, help us to be strong and patient in our difficulties. glorious hope in your promise. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my friends, that this sacrifice of ours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously accept, O Lord, the gift we offer, that our partaking of them may free us from sin and purify our hearts for the glorious coming of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Together, let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all tell. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of glory, as without end we are praying.
Oh.
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time was betrayed and entered willingly his passion. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave the disciples, saying, "Take this, all you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "This, all you drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. You do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forevermore. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, you said to us now, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Friends and sisters, brothers, let's start from here, and after Mass go beyond here to share this blessing with each other, with the people outside. So may the peace of our risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
You have renewed us, Lord, by these wonderful gifts. As we prepare for the mystery of Christ's birth, grant that we may rejoice in this gift of eternal life. We ask this in the name of Jesus our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the parish announcement. As we celebrate the joyful Christmas season, may we also remember those in need. We are appealing for food donations for the brothers and sisters among us, including canned food, rice, or any non-perishable food like eggs and drinks. You may bring your gifts and presents that present them during the offering procession on Christmas Day and New Year's Day. Our Christmas Mass schedule is as follows. 24th of December, Christmas Eve, midnight Masses, are 9 p.m. at the car park, Mass in the Gallo. 9 p.m. in the church, Mass in English, 12 a.m. in the car park, Mass in English, and 12 a.m. in the church, Mass in English. Our Christmas Day, 25th of December, Mass schedule is the same as the Sunday Mass schedule. For details, please refer to the notice board. Thank you. Please all stand for the final blessing.
Okay, since you're silent, so don't need to sit. So, just before the blessing, just want to say, thank you very much for our Reverend Bishop Stephen Joe. I also would like to say, my dear brothers and sisters, for 9 days novena, tonight, the Honorable Bishop Stephen Joe complete our 2022 Christmas, this 9 days novena. Simonity complete. So congratulations for 9 days. I know not easy. Since 2018, so our church was the first church in Hong Kong started this novena mass already 4 years. But the last year we did not have a Christmas celebration, but this year we make it really thanks God. And we have a such celebration every night. Is full of the church every night, and then we praise God, prepare ourselves for this Christmas for the newborn King. So I also want to say, all what we dream, all what we thank, so may God bless us, and also thanks very much for the BLP. Group for our reading the choir. And also thank you very much for our every year in Bangladesh we have a special choir team. So they also did the last 5 days in Bangladesh was singing. Each year our Zimbabwe must all these collections, if all will support the special need of our parishioners in Philippines, all our parishioners of Filipina parishioner who need whatever the things. So every year when the Zimbabwe must complete, I used to announce feel free to apply for this finance need. And in every year we support more than 100 Filipino parishioners through this Simbang Limas from our first time. So feel free, I said. And also you'll see this Christmas coming, and we're going to have another mass. Not Christmas only, but also New Year, we have a countdown mass at 10:45, 31st of December. So every year, that's some special mass. And be ready, and then welcome to join. And our bishop very support us when we ask him whether he can complete our Zimbabwe mass, visit us. And the bishop is very, very quickly and answer that all. Thank you. So we will see our bishop again on the 1st of January. So, because you know what's happened in the 1st of January. You don't know yet, isn't it? I cannot wait to tell you on the 1st of January, but let me tell you now. 1st of January, we will ask our Reverend Bishop Stephen Jo to announce that our St. Joseph Church 150 years anniversary starts. So the slogan is for the 150 years anniversary, which is Home Away from Home. So many of us left the home. So let us build a home in Hong Kong, which is away from our home. So that's what we try to do the last year, but we especially do 2022. So thank you very much. We ask us to have our piece of discussion from friends.
Okay, my friends, the sisters, brothers, may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow down for the blessing. May the Almighty and Merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of His only begotten Son, and yearn for His coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with His blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may He make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when He comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit
Amen.
Come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
So, my friends, together with great joy,